I think what I'm working at in particular in this painting is the balance between the blues, the oranges, and the cream color, and how all of those work together. How, for instance, these sections here, these shapes, all interlock in such a way that you can't separate one from the other. I particularly like the richness of the colors that have been scraped so that you can see the colors through each other. This painting, called Red Wing, slightly different format and very dramatic use of light and dark contrast. The black color is most important in setting the tone of this painting. But once again, you have to stand back a ways to get the whole, as I say, the architecture of the picture plane. There are different kinds of edges in this painting as opposed to the others. More emphasis on curves and scallops and whatnot. Notice that this painting, and as is true many of the others, are divided in the center, and that's very purposeful on my part because I like working with the composition from each edge in. I just use it as a compositional device so that the shapes that work down the center are interconnecting between the two edges. This painting is called Grand Marais, and the name comes from a place where my parents spent their honeymoon, on the north shore of Lake Michigan. This painting, like the other, is a contrast between more curvilinear forms and more angular forms. But it's also thematic in its emphasis on color blue, a variety of blues, really, and those colors that set that contrast off, such as these kind of taupe colors here, and the oranges, and so on. Okay, this painting is called In the Light of Day. I looked at it for a long time after I thought it was complete, and it had to me a certain feeling, and I couldn't capture that in words, except to say that it reminded me of a kind of summer light, morning light in summer. In this particular painting, there are more of these linear elements here and in the center. They all start with those kinds of elements. All the paintings begin from a kind of drawing. And sometimes the drawing remains. More often than not, the drawing disappears. Now, sections like this, most of the linear elements are gone. And here they are retained. It all depends upon the color and the contrast that is set up between the more active or complicated areas as opposed to the larger, simpler areas of color. And particularly like the contrast in this painting between the warm oranges and so on and the blacks and the isolation of the blacks and oranges, and when you see the green as it becomes blue here. And here, of course, they simply follow through. But in other places, they stop at the edge. So you're moving back and forth between emphasizing and de-emphasizing the separation. Maiden Rock is a town on the Mississippi River, dividing a section that divides Wisconsin and Minnesota. This is on the Minnesota side. It's famous for its pottery and so on, but it also happens to be a town next to where my grandmother grew up. So you have here three basic sections. So the two parts divide, and the center divides them. Now, Where she grew up, there are these bluffs that go down to the Mississippi River, and they look very much like this, actually. Big, tall rock formations on the edge of the river, and so you go down to the river from there. That's part of, I suppose, some connection in the painting. I call this one Silver Lake because it seemed to fit the silvery quality of the black. In most of my paintings, you get contrast between very flat, solid chunks of color and then ones that are much more fragile and transparent. And that's created by putting down paint on various degrees of thickness. These are very thin, this is much heavier, and so on. My name is Neil Anderson. This is my one-person exhibition at the Bridget Mayer Gallery. This is my fifth exhibition with Bridget. And so it's my first one in this new gallery renovation.